We're going to learn how to rename and delete bulk AF elements using the PyAF Builder for Microsoft Excel. Now, in Microsoft Excel, we've got our PyAF Builder here, and we can connect to a database by clicking on that blue database button. We can select our Py system or AF server, and then select the database, which for us was tanks, and then go to elements, and so find elements will allow us to pick out those elements that we want to rename today. And we have some tanks here in the tank farm, so we're going to select the root tank farm, and then search for the tank template. And now we have some tanks, so we're going to select all of those holding the shift key down. And when I click OK, it brings me to this menu, which is the columns we're going to work with. Today, I don't need any of the columns except new names. So I'm going to clear all the columns, select new name, which is the renaming feature. And when I click OK, it'll come back here. Here's our list. And there's our tanks that we're going to rename. Now, to rename them, I'm going to use a familiar Excel function, which is text concatenation. So I'm just going to type in equal and storage and a blank and close my double quote here. And then put an ampersand and point back at the name of the element, which was in this case tank A. And then you'll notice it didn't quite work right, and that's because the cells were formatted for text. So I'm going to come back and format them generally. I selected the whole column and formatted those for general, which is an Excel feature here. And when I put that back in a little bit, you'll see it'll say storage tank A. So we've effectively added storage to the front of this. As we copy this to all the rows here, we'll be able to name all these tanks. And we could do that for many, many tanks, thousands of them. So I'm going to click on the export button and select edit, and when I click OK, it'll upload those changes to those six tanks, and if we come back to System Explorer, we can now refresh and we'll see those six tanks have been named from tank to storage tank. Now our next task was that we wanted to delete some elements. And I've decided today we're not going to delete all of our tanks, but just the tanks D, E, and F, the last three. So we're going to keep storage tanks A, B, and C. To do that, we're going to use PyAF Builder and go to our elements search, as we did before, and select Find Elements. And we can use the same selection, but now they're named storage tanks, as we confirmed, and we'll hold the Shift key down and click OK. And when we select our fields that we'll have in the worksheet, we don't need new name anymore, just the very minimum parent name and object type, and here they are. And if we tried to delete now, it's not available. And this is because there's a setting in the PyAF Builder settings button that allows deletion. So we're going to click on the settings button. This is to avoid accidental deletions. Now I mentioned that we're not going to delete tanks A, B, and C, storage tanks A, B, and C. So we're going to remove the X's. We click the delete button, it'll ask us if we really do want to delete them. It'll confirm the tanks that it's deleted. When we click OK, now if we go down to System Explorer and hit refresh, we'll see the tanks D, E, and F are now gone. Now we had that setting in PyAF Builder, which was going to prevent accidental deletions. So it's probably a good idea to put that safety back on and unclick that box so we won't have an accidental deletion.